Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Dennis Prager Show. Oh, there's a huge global. Well, that I was going to reserve for tomorrow because it's a huge issue, but it's worth noting. And I will note it for a moment here because there's a major piece. There are a few major pieces out, by the way. But there really is a major piece out on what is happening. There is a man. Here we go. There's a whistleblower out there. This is a big deal. So I'm going to cover this in greater depth tomorrow, but I want you to know this. This is from the Daily Mail. Exposed: how world leaders were duped into investing billions over manipulated global warming data. The whistleblower is a major climatologist and named John J. Bates, and he blew the whistle to the Mail on Sunday. The Mail on Sunday reveals astonishing evidence that the organization that is the world's leading source of climate data rushed to publish a landmark paper that exaggerated global warming and was timed to influence the historic Paris Agreement on climate change. And you know what organization that is? The one that they always cite now? The NOAA, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. A high-level whistleblower has told this newspaper that America's National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, NOAA, breached its own rules on scientific integrity when it published the sensational but flawed report aimed at making the maximum possible impact on world leaders, including Barack Obama and David Cameron, at the UN Climate Conference in Paris in 2015. The report claimed that the pause or slowdown in global warming in the period since 1998, revealed by UN scientists in 2013, never existed, and that world temperatures had been rising faster than scientists expected. Launched by NOAA with a public relations fanfare, it was splashed across the world's media and cited repeatedly by politicians and policymakers. But the whistleblower, Dr. John Bates, a top NOAA scientist with an impeccable reputation, has shown the Mail on Sunday irrefutable evidence that the paper was based on misleading, unverified data. It was never subjected to NOAA's rigorous internal evaluation process, which Dr. Bates himself devised. Wow. The left has poisons everything it touches, and it's even true for science. It's already ruined our universities in the liberal arts, and it is beginning to do it through the environmentalist movement into the natural sciences. So what will this man who was an official with the NOAA, what will he now be called? A climate denier?
A tool of industry?
Right. You know, they've been telling us it's the hottest year. Did they ever report to you that it is a fraction? It's like 0.01% of a degree increase, which is so within the realm of error that it's pointless. It's pointless to even speak of this being the hottest year on record. It means nothing. But this is what people believe. People believe, totally understandably, what they're told over and over and over and over. And therefore, any of us who have any dissent on these matters is considered someone who just doesn't believe in truth. Because they have told you only one side of this issue, and they deny that there is another side. There's a lot going on in the climate area. It doesn't seem like any of the catastrophes that have been predicted have in fact happened, do they? we were supposed to have calamitous events take place years ago already. And this is a while. Al Gore came out with his book in the 1990s, Earth in the Balance. God, I remember critiquing it then because he said the greatest problem facing mankind is environmental catastrophe. It's in the 1990s. And I remember broadcasting saying, no, the greatest threat to mankind is human evil, not environmental catastrophe.